Hi, everybody. My name is Sean, and I am a 20-year smoker, no more, and very happy about it. This video specifically addresses, pretty much picking up a electronic cigarette from a couple of different avenues, from a local gas station, tobacco shops, things of that nature, and then especially you hear radio advertisements, things of that nature. Why I'm bringing this up to a point is I, of course, have heard a lot of comments and talked to a lot of people where, unfortunately, they have wound up with a product that really didn't work for them in the beginning, but as they did due diligence, they went on to the electronic cigarette forum, ECF, as it's called. Great place to go. I highly recommend it. Many of us call it our Bible. When I first started out, that's one of the areas that I actually went into. And now I'm here not to tell you that every product out there is bad. I'm sure that there are a lot of great ones that are out there. But what I am here to tell you is there are a lot of not so great products that has come out. The electronic cigarette industry in the United States is booming, and you're really seeing it more from the South and traveling upwards, a little bit in the Midwest, and of course a little bit in the West, but of course hasn't captured the United States completely. What's pretty much happening is you have a lot of people who like what I like to call it, they're looking at the short nickel and not the long dime, and they're trying to, you know, get rich quick, and what it is they're trying to buy product the cheapest that they can. And then, of course, you know, sell it as a wholesaler, whatever it might be, and then have it actually in a retail establishment. Of course, the retailer is trying to make money on it. The middleman is trying to make money on it and things of that nature. And, of course, with this product mainly coming out of China, you really do have a big range if you're a supplier as far as what you would choose to actually offer to people out there. So, of course, they're getting the bottom, you know, type electronic cigarette out there, and they're putting it out there. And as a consumer, of course, when you walk in, you're like, hey, I want, you know, the cheapest thing. And this is something I'm really telling you right now, you know, as $8 for a pack of cigarettes, $9, wherever you might be, you look at what you're spending on a carton. If you're a serious smoker, take the time to really look into this. I'm a 20-year smoker. I don't smoke anymore. I can't tell you how many people I know, 20, 30, 40, 50-year smoker. That's right. I've actually talked to somebody who is a 50-year smoker who has changed over. And we're talking two packs a day, pack and a half a day, three packs a day, and they don't use regular tobacco cigarettes anymore. And the trick with it is this thing that you see right here, I'm not changing my habit. I'm just changing what I'm using. I'm getting rid of the tar. I'm getting rid of a lot of the carcinogens, things of that nature. But what is happening, and something that for me is kind of upsetting, is these really cheap products are being put out there. And what happens is you go in there, you're like, oh, wow, $20. You know, I'll buy that. I'll try that out. And it doesn't work for you, or it doesn't really work very well. Well, you get what you pay for, don't you? And this is something where, you know, go onto the forums, wherever it might be, check it out a little bit more. There are products that really will work, but you're going to have to pay for it. You know, I mean, $50, $60, $70, whatever it might be, depending on the different e-cig stuff that you do have actually out there. But look for the good models. Manual unit, the 510, this is the one that I'm really big on. This is a great unit that you have right there. But really check that out. And, of course, be very aware. And I'm not saying don't buy from a radio advertisement or something that you have right there, but what I am telling you is before you buy from them, you know, Google it, and don't just look at the first page. Go to the second or third page and really look down into it. There's a lot of free trial offers out there that you do see, which, you know, a month later you have a $100 charge that has been put on your credit card. I've heard of all these things and the automatic stuff. So be careful of all that out there, everybody. You know, a couple of things to really look at is if it's a regular cartridge and they're trying to put you on a program to sell you cartridges all the time, that's something that you want to look a little bit deeper into. So this is just kind of a nice quick video as far as, you know, some of the disposables that you see out there. And hey, if you're a regular e-cig smoker and you hear somebody who says, yeah, I try one of those, I don't really like them, they're, you know, not all that great, ask them, hey, where'd you buy it? What kind of unit did you actually get? Because for me personally, I was lucky enough to start this out 8 months ago. It's worked really well for me, and now I'm seeing this explosion happening throughout the United States of all of these very inadequate models popping up on the market, and it's really ruining it for somebody who truly wants to start out, they truly want to have something different as far as a the alternative to a regular tobacco cigarette. And this does work if you really check it out. So all I'm telling you is check it out. All right, everybody. I think I'm done for now. Talk to you later.